Dr. Lemoine really, truly exemplifies the characteristics of an ideal nursing professor.
She is the embodiment of the consummate professional and consummate educator.
She is so committed to the profession, to the college, to the department, to the university, and of course, first and foremost, to our students.
I wasn't always a nurse. I was in banking, and my happiest customers were nurses. And I felt that I had something to give at the end of the day that I wasn't getting in a different profession.
In nursing, she's received multiple degrees up through the doctoral level with the Doctor of Nursing Practice credential.
I focused on neonatal nursing because it is such a vulnerable population. But I always was a teacher. As a bedside nurse, there's always a level of teaching that's done. And several people pointed out to me that I was really good at it. So combining the nursing aspect and the teaching aspect was really the perfect fit for me.
She's taken her role as a mentor to the highest that she can take it.
A lot of our doctoral students work full-time and are not available during university hours and really need to be in communication with Dr. Lemoine after hours. And that's something that Jen does on the weekends, on her own time.
My husband understands that within reason, the students do come first. I remember what it was like to need to know the answer to a question. And if I can help them to succeed, and it's not necessarily between the hours of 9 and 5, then I'm willing to do that.
Jennifer is really very widely recognized and has really developed into quite an expert in the area of health policy.
When the Louisiana legislature is in session, Dr. Lemoine organizes all of the students to make sure that they have personal advocacy experiences at the state capitol in Baton Rouge. That's going way above and beyond what is expected of an educator.
She is tireless in her efforts to advance the scope of practice for nurse practitioners in Louisiana.
Other nurse practitioners recognize her skill at advocacy and skill in health policy. That's a tremendous asset, not just to our community, but to all the citizens of Louisiana.
When she's called to help, she doesn't say no.
It's very humbling and exciting to think that I am recognized at the level that I feel that this honor holds. In gratitude of my professorship, this goes out to Mr. and Mrs. Jim Doyle. I so appreciate your belief in me, that you have continued to endorse me for this professorship. It has allowed me to be able to take that extra time and conduct the research, to be published, to travel, to get that message out for the nursing profession, for nurses at the bedside, for neonatal nurses. I would like to thank Dr. Melinda Oberleitner. She believed in me. She saw something in me that maybe I couldn't see in myself. Dr. Gail Poirier, who nominated me for this award, and Dr. Helen Hurst, the graduate coordinator, who is my biggest cheerleader. I really don't know where I would be without these ladies. And last but not least, Dr. Lisa Broussard, who helped me achieve my first publication and kind of get me started in that realm of scholarship. All those hours are worth it. Absolutely worth it. And that's why I continue to do it today. It's easy to come in, do your job, and go home. It's difficult to go that extra mile, but it's worth it in the end.